Peter, a very good morning to you and a Merry Christmas to all our friends back at the television centre. Have a good day.
Thank you very much and good luck with the
well,
show, Noel.
We are up the top of the telecom tower and we've got a great show for you. The view over London live on this Christmas Day morning, Christmas Day 1985, wherever you are in the United Kingdom or in ERA, we wish you a very happy Christmas. We're up the top there, 620 feet above London. British Telecom's micro radio network link is all set here. I'll tell you a little bit more about what the tower does in a while. I can promise you a Christmas show you are not going to be able to put down or forget for the next 2 hours. These idiots are all going running up the tower, trying to establish a new world record for doing that, and they're going to be earning a tremendous amount for charity at the same time. We have here our telephone people who are ready to take your calls. Why not give us a call this morning? And they will write down all the details. You want to say Merry Christmas to somebody, we'll flash it up on the screen if we possibly can. Good morning, Happy Christmas to you. It's 637-7171. We're also, this year, going to be putting all the dedications on CFAX as well. And that's going to come up on CFAX page 189. Have you got one for me, Viv?
Merry Christmas.
Jill, oh, I can't read that. What's that say? Is that Tease?
Congratulations to Di and Chris Utton.
Oh, it's Jill who rang in from Salisbury. Congratulations to Di and Chris Utton on the birth of their first child at 12:15 this morning. Charlotte Louise weighed in at 8 pounds and 4 ounces, and all their family and friends in Hayes are thrilled to bits. So congratulations. Welcome to the world, Charlotte. And as I've been mentioning on the Late Late Breakfast Show on Saturday evenings over the last couple of weeks, a percentage of all the money from the calls that we receive today will be donated by British Telecom to a new charity. I'll tell you about that charity in a moment. But thanks to the generosity of Telecom, we already have inside this computer here over £10,000, because there are 54,000 names inside the computer, and we'll be doing the world's first ever computer draw later on, a special competition which allows us to present some absolutely splendid prizes. Also, the money from the race is going to be used for a charity called Comic Relief. This is a brand new charity that has been established by some of the biggest names in British comedy. They're planning live shows, a book, a record, and all the money raised by Comic Relief will be distributed to Oxfam and Save the Children to help with their relief programs in Ethiopia and the Sudan. The money is going to be used to support nurses, water engineers, nutritionists, mechanics, and people such as that. All the money we raise on the show today will be going to one camp in the Sudan, Safawa. It's a Christmas treat that we've got lined up for the relief workers, because we are going to be linking up live with that particular camp in the Sudan. How we've arranged this, we will also be explaining, because it has been a mammoth job. We have had to move a satellite dish 4,000 miles. We've had to put it on one of the biggest planes in the world. We've had to move it across a desert. And we've also had to press gang somehow a team of BBC volunteers to go out there. We'll be meeting them in just a little while. Also, to launch Comic Relief, and a lot of the faces you've just seen there will be featured in the next 2 hours, to launch it, we've got 10 of the finest comedians in the UK and given them 10 of the most difficult audiences to perform in front of. That's in a while. Last year when I was up here, we had something like 11 million people watching. I can promise you this year a show that really is international, because we're going around the country, all over the place. I'm in London. We'll also be going up to Linlithgow, up in Scotland. So a very happy Christmas to all our Scottish viewers up in Linlithgow. There they are, the cross and the townhouse. Also, we're going over to Belfast as well. There's Belfast at a a lonely Santa. I shouldn't think he'd be lonely for much longer. Why not come down there and join in with the fun? Cardiff as well. Hello to everybody in Wales who's watching us. Hello. Yes, he's sounding desperate down there. That's Keith Hatton and Hugh Thomas. He's sounding desperate. Go along to Cardiff. Newcastle as well. We're linking up with Newcastle. Hello to everybody up in the northeast. A Merry Christmas. It looks solitary at the Manor Car Park. I'm quite certain they'll rush along to and join Catherine Clegg up there. Leeds. Hello, Leeds. In Leeds, we've got John Naylor, ably assisted by the constabulary. And a rather charming lady as well. We'll come back to Leeds in a bit. Manchester. Good morning, Manchester. Hello, another lonely face in Manchester. We've got Tudor Nash Jones. Hello, Tudor. Merry Christmas to you. I'm sure he'll be joined by some people in a while. Birmingham as well. We're going to Birmingham. I told you, it's a real international show. The Idiots at Pebble Mill, led by Caroline Matthews, are waiting for you to join them. If you're anywhere near the mill, pop along in Birmingham. Norwich. Good morning, Norwich. It's nearly good afternoon now. And all our friends up there in East Anglia, Merry Christmas to you. Down to Bristol, down to the west, that's where we're going as well. Hello!
Hello!
There's Cliff White and the rest of the team in Bristol. And finally, Plymouth. That completes our national lineup, our international lineup, as we go to Scotland and Wales and Ireland. And I know the programme is being taken by ERA as well. And now, a first, an absolute first for the show that loves to bring you first, to Gatwick, where we have an aeroplane, a very special aeroplane. It's Virgin Airlines 747 Jumbo Jet. There it is on the runway. And on board we've got the Crankies and we've got Gary Davis. And for the first time ever, we are going to be bringing you live television pictures from a commercial airliner. It's never been done before. Hello, Crankies!
Hiya, Noel! Merry Christmas here!
And Merry Christmas.
Here we are on the 747 Jumbo Jet. As Noel said, a BBC World of course. We got 200 kids here.
Everybody happy!
Hey. We've got Paul King behind me.
Yeah, and we've got Fergal Sharky.
Fergal Sharky.
Wherever we wave.
Right now.
Upstairs. We've got Nicholas here, and he's got something
to tell. He's got a Walkman.
Oh, be quiet a minute. I want to see if I've got on
here
a lady with an amazing name, Merry Christmas. Hello, Mary. Hello, what a wonderful name to have. You're in Millwall, are you?
I am, on the Isle of Dogs.
And you know that you have a great moment of power now.
I do have.
Can you see your television set?
I can.
That aeroplane sitting there is waiting for just your word. And this is absolutely true. Air traffic control have cooperated. The flight crew are ready to go. Their hands are on the throttles. There they are. They're all ready for you. They're waiting.
Oh, boy.
And the moment you say go, Mary, they will go. So in your own time.
Yeah. Anyway, children, this is Merry Christmas. I'm wishing you a very Merry Christmas. Hope you have a lovely time. And off you go, boys.
There. She said go. The throttles are going forward. Captain Eric Davies is in charge. There you see our camera that is on the flight deck. This is a first for the show. It's never been done before, live pictures from a commercial airliner, the Virgin Atlantic Airlines 747. 400 tons of jumbo jet has just been set off by Merry Christmas in the Isle of Dogs. A Merry Christmas to you, Mary. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Noel.
Have a wonderful time in the Isle of Dogs. I bet you wish you were on that plane. Bye-bye. The first officer is Andy Whitson. It's gathering up speed, as you can see. And I think that's quite a moment for Mary in the Isle of Dogs to have the chance to actually cue a jumbo jet. We have, of course, our helicopter showing you there, 400 tons of 747 clambering into the sky. It is going to be going the length of the country. If you're in Norwich, with a bit of luck, you'll see it. It'll be going over Leeds. It's going over Manchester as well. We'll be going on board throughout the next 2 hours and showing you some of those lovely kids who are having, in so many ways, the flight of a lifetime. And thank goodness the cloud has lifted for us. We were really terrified as to whether or not we'd be able to see this. The cloud has been very, very low over London. There she is from our cameras on the ground. We'll find out where those cameras are in just a little while. But she starts her course, her two-hour flight, and she's well and truly on her way. Don't forget to give us a call. It's 637 7171 if you'd like to take part in dedications on this live breakfast show. And I'd like to say hello to just a couple of people. Well, I'm allowed to. Get a show of your own if you want to say hello to somebody. I'd say hello to Olive and Roe and Mew and Alice, who are up there in Carlisle, and to Andy and Linda, who I'll be having a bit of Christmas dinner with later on, and to the Woods family, who are down in Axbridge. I'd also like to say hello to someone who can't be with us today. That's our floor manager, Ian McLean. I mean, he's here, but he hasn't been with us all morning. Quick, come here and let's have a look at the cardigan. He has got the most wonderful... Faster, we've got a lot to put into the show.
Well, you made me
look at this. What a wonderful card. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Can I go now?
Yes, you may.
Bye.
Already over £10,000 has been pledged by British Telecom. Our computer competition will be coming in just a little while. John Cleese, Rowan Atkinson will be joining me. The 747 is up and away into the sky, but coming down to Earth, yes, I can see it now, we have Smitty, who's in a helicopter, one of the two helicopters that we've got working for us today. And he is on to a very special site at Rusper. If you are near the village of Rusper, you will be able to see that helicopter on its way. It's got Smitty on board. Also still to come, of course, we have our real piece of history today. We'll be linking up with the Sudan, with the relief camp out there, for which we are raising, we hope, literally tens of thousands of pounds of money today. Smitty's on board the helicopter that you can see there, and he has got lined up the most ridiculous selection of games to play and various challenges that he's going to be putting to an exclusive team of loonies. Live breakfast show, of course, wishing you wherever you are in the UK, indeed if you are watching the pictures in the Sudan, wishing you a very Merry Christmas indeed. And here he comes. Oh, what? Well, I thought my pullover was bad. Hello!
Merry Christmas!
And Merry Christmas to you.
How you doing?
I thought I looked daft, but you've beaten me.
It's all right. It's better than Ian McLean's cardigan, isn't it?
Yeah. Where did you get that outfit from?
Well, I actually borrowed it off one of the stewardesses on board the jumbo jet before she took off. They wear these on board Virgin Airlines, you know. Very nice, isn't it?
Yes, lovely.
We have got some wonderful things lined up for you. We're at Gill Manor Hotel, Noel, which is in a village called Rusper in Sussex. And we've got the entire village just turned out here this morning under the lawns of the hotel because we've got some wonderful games lined up. There you can see the course and a few of the people standing around. And in fact, just behind me, we've got the competitors for the first event, which will be happening very shortly. We're doing a Crizzy Dizzy race. Now, a Crizzy Dizzy race looks like this. If you want to have a go at it at home this morning, if you've got a broom and a back garden, for heaven's sake, if you live in a flat, don't go on the balcony and try this. Got a broom, you've got to hold it up like that, and you've got to turn around six times and then try and run in a straight line. And it's impossible, but you'll see that in just a moment. We move over here because we've got this man in here. This is a fridge, by the way. If you didn't know what it is a fridge. And any moment now, we have got Ice Bow.
Hello.
Ice Bow, good
morning. Good
morning. What's your real name?
My real name is Anthony Irvin.
What can you do?
What I can do, I'm going to do now. I'm going to melt this huge pile of frozen ice.
This huge pile of ice over here. How are you going to melt it?
But my matches are all damp, so I'm in confusion. I wonder if you've got a dry match.
Well, we'll come back to you later on, Ice Bow. I don't know where the hell we got in from. Right, let's try over here. Here we have the villagers of Rusper in Sussex. Merry Christmas, Rusper! They're all completely ratted here. This is the village punch which has been made. We brought Jonathan McKenna, who's a professional wine taster with us, to try the punch. How is it, John?
It's absolutely delicious. All the local villagers have actually made it themselves. We're on lots of recipes, but there's a special thing that I want you to try, Michael.
Yes.
It's absolutely gorgeous. The local village kids have
been
out pillaging
the punch
countryside.
Too much, do you? Pillaging the countryside
to get these wonderful chestnuts here. Now, you must try them.
Very nice. No, that's all right. You have them, John. That's okay. No problem. Sorry. In the punch. For heaven's sake. Right, we've got to go over here.
Sorry about that, children.
We've got some people over here, Noel, who are going to do a race. We have a dizzy race going on.
Yeah.
Where's me klaxon? Oh, hang on.
Mike,
yes.
Where did you get all these people from?
These are the villagers of Rusper.
Oh, good. Well, that's a place to avoid, obviously.
It's a wonderful place to be today. Now, the dizzy race coming up. Here we go. Are you ready? Put your brooms up in the air, please. Right up, come on, hold them right up. Right up. These are all little stockbrokers, really. Right, here we go. You're off. I've started it. That was the whistle. Come on. Twist round six times. That's it. Now run in a straight line. Come on, then run. So there's a lot of that going on today, a few other things as well. I should be dropping in on a cricket match in Wimbledon with the helicopter, because we'll be finding out whether Christmas cricket players keep holly inside their Christmas boxes. And we've also got Jeff Stevenson here today, who's helping with the welly running competition, and he's just filling up the wellies ready for the welly running competition at this moment.
How are you, mate?
It's all, very well, Jeff. Merry Christmas. It's all happening here in Merry Rusper.
I think we're in trouble already.
Thank you, Smitty. We're in trouble with something. Please, it's if you want to dial, and we'd love to hear from you, it's 01 outside London, 637-7171, 637-7171. I understand quite a few people have been misdialing. But do please call us. All the calls we get are going to help us raise quite a bit of money for a relief camp in the Sudan, which we'll be going to live very, very shortly indeed. Now, if you're in the regions, and we had a quick run around all the locations where we've got cameras, if you think that you'd like to get down to one of those cameras, we've got some interesting prizes for you there, and we've got also what I think are some quite interesting challenges. We would like the first people there, please, wearing national costume, but not your own. So if you're in Wales, don't turn up with the Welsh national costume on, and no kilts up there in Scotland. You must turn up in national costume, but not your own. Or would you please take a door, and we will give an extra prize if it happens to be a front door as well. And also, we've got a wonderful prize for the first person to turn up at any of the locations with a fried egg. Would you please fry it well, because we are going to get the stage managers there to eat the eggs. If you want to do horrible eggs, I really don't mind, but you must fry them as well as you possibly can. We've got a Whirly World Challenge, of course, today. It's a challenge with a difference, but if you were watching last Saturday, you'll know that everybody who had their name on our Whirly Wheel qualifies for doing something. And the something is going to be rather interesting. That's also happening around the regions. Chaz Greatrix is our Whirly Wheeler from Cardiff, who's going to be hanging around just outside the telecom tower. But inside it, we've got a race with a difference, because, of course, we have our great telecom tower Grand Prix. It's 620 feet from the street up here, 816 steps. We had the heats yesterday, and this is how they got on yesterday afternoon.
Behind me, a real rabble of people who are all about to take part in the first heats that we have for a world first. The first Grand Prix up the British Telecom Tower. They're going to be running up 620 feet of stairs. They're doing it all for charity. There's ladies and gentlemen out here, nearly 50 of them. Only six of them can go through to tomorrow's final. Which six will it be?
Go on, up to the starting line.
I don't think I've ever met such a mad bunch of people. Although, having said that, I think that down at Rusper, Smitty's got a fair few nutters. As you can see, we tried to make it look as professional as possible, and they rallied round and turned up in the most amazing outfits. If you think running with a bird on your head is difficult, try running with a frying pan. That man, as it says on his jacket there, takes part in lots of marathons. And he did well. He wasn't the worst one by any means, but he does look rather tired. Now, can you imagine running up 816 steps in a suit of armour? We assumed he would take it off at some point. But, well, all will be revealed in a while. There's the First Lady. We had a number of young ladies joined us yesterday. Much appreciated by the men, as you can see. She's waiting for her time to go, and away she runs. Was she one of the winning six? Oh, he's at it. I think Mike Smith would describe him as knackered. And there we go. Number 28 comes in, looking pretty bushed as well. They were a wonderful bunch of people. Do remember, they were all being sponsored, some for some very large sums of money indeed, so the sweat was well and truly worth it, even for Gavin's models. A nice pretty ankle, and the rest ain't bad either. We had to hold on to the camera crew and stop them running after her. She was on her way. Come in, number 35. How about that? Imagine running up the tower, phone a flower. Here he is. We had to get a can opener to him afterwards. There's another one gone completely. They were all so cocky at the beginning. 620 feet later, it was a different matter. Now, in Manchester, have we got somebody in Manchester who turned up with a door? I don't believe it.
It's the Macro Education Project in Manchester. We're fasting for Ethiopia today.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Now, where did you get the door from? I only mentioned it about 2 minutes ago.
It's from our project. We're just over the road, behind the camera. The camera's there, behind me, over there.
And you unscrewed it and brought it over?
No, it was already unscrewed.
Oh, was it?
Yeah.
Well done.
We're going to fry an egg, though. though, because we're starving.
Well done. Thank you for your door. Now, we have got, in fact, seven people in our tower final, because the fastest ones yesterday were a pair, and they managed to do it in under 5 minutes, which is quite incredible. They reckon they can improve, in fact, on 4 minutes and 53 seconds. Thousands of pounds of sponsorship is running on this. So if our timers downstairs can hear me at the foot of the telecom tower, could we start our finalists off, please? Number 49 is Mark, and he did it in 5:16 yesterday. He's on for £1,500 from Ski Yogurt, and away goes Mark Cleanthios, I think his name is. Waiting to go behind him is Derek Guglianotti. Have we got any English people taking part? Derek actually is from Aberdeen. He's come all the way from Scotland. £1,500 of sponsorship. And he did it yesterday also in 5 minutes and 16 seconds. There goes Derek. Now, I wasn't joking about the names here. This is Kim. Kim Jungruthmeyer. And he's from Ryslip. He was 1 second faster yesterday. £700 minimum he is getting for various charities, and he's passing the money on to us. He's away. And we do believe we might well have a good traffic jam, because the speed that they are going at is amazing. Norman Stenson is also going to go running. Thomas Davis, Les Shortreed, and following at the end, Chris Sweeney and Stuart Bradstock. They'll be with me in just a little while. Chaz Greatorex is going to be doing our Daring Whirly Wheel Challenge, but as I mentioned, all the Whirly Wheelers on the last Saturday edition of the Late Labour Acres Show are doing things for us here, around the region. It's a pretty daring challenge, and of course, we've had to put them through some pretty exhaustive training during the week with Mr. Abdul Hassani.
This is for a high tea.
The hero.
Six 377 7171. If you want to see your name pass underneath our screen on this Christmas day, to Lynn Lithgow to find out how Alan Cousins is getting on with the glasses. Alan was Whirly Wheeler from Scotland, and he's there at Lynn Lithgow. He's 24 years old. He in fact comes from Prestwick, and he's attempting to balance glasses without whiskey in them, which is extremely difficult for a Scotsman. We're counting the number of glasses, and we will have an international winner by the end of the programme. Look at the concentration on his face there. And from Linlithgow, we go to Belfast, where the Whirly Wheeler over there is Gerard Brown. Hello, Gerard. Pick up your glasses. Stop posing around. Yeah, get on with it. He's 27. He's from Derry. He's obviously been drinking too much already. He's bought... Are you going to do anything, Gerard? Would you like to get on with it? he's bought over 200 gallons of petrol to get those glasses. In Norwich, we've got Neil Billig. Hello, Neil.
Hello.
29 from Wroxham. Would you like to have a go at your challenge, please? He's from Wroxham in Norfolk. What about Wroxham? He smashes them quite well. We'll be adding all these up and seeing who is our Christmas Day winner. Try counting those at home. I can't work out how many he's got there. It certainly looks a lot more than the chap in Belfast. We can go down to the southwest, to Plymouth, where there's a little touch of elegance I can see there, from Monty Pugh. Monty, go to it, if you would, please. Monty Pugh, he's 25, he's an engine technician with the RAF. Says he doesn't like glasses, prefers contact lenses. That's right, isn't it, Monty?
That's right, Noel.
Johnny, good. He's just sorting himself out. Alison Francis is in Rusper. No. Hello.
Oh, I didn't touch the drop yet, and I'm completely gone.
Have you got Alison as well as Abdul there?
Yes, I have. But listen, I want to play you a tune. My musical badge.
Oh, lovely.
Isn't that nice? That's from Rebecca, who's 7 years old. Thank you, Rebecca. This is Alison.
Hello, Alison. Hello. How many glasses do you think you can pick up?
I don't know. It's sort of ready for me at the moment.
Right, well, if you'd like to have a bash at it, we can sort of compare it with the ones we've been looking at so far.
Okay.
Right, have a go. Quick, up you go. We've got Abdul here, the man who's got the record.
30 trains at last.
Yes, sir, this is which is
and of course, incredible. while you're watching this,
she can't even lift him.
We've got. We've got people running up the inside of the tower, and we're waiting for the first ones to arrive. And I don't believe this. These are the fried eggs that have arrived at various places. Bristol was the first one. Who have we got there with a fried egg in Bristol?
Hello, we've got three now. The first one to arrive was Joe.
Hang on, Cliff, just hang on a second. The first idiot's arrived up the tower now. Who's that? Number 49. That's Mark. Bristol, sorry, Cliff, to interrupt you. We had our first tower runner-up.
Okay, well...
Who you got there?
I think we'll send him the fried egg. He needs the strength. We've got Joan and Bert who arrived the very first to arrive with their fried egg.
Merry Christmas, Joan and Bert. Thank you for doing that. We'll give you a nice prize for it. Bristol beat the rest of the country thanks to Joan and Bert. Now, Alison Francis, as you saw, was picking up all the glasses there. Downstairs here in London, we've got Alan Chester, who's outside the telecom tower, and he is doing the challenge for the London end. That's right, isn't it? Oh, we haven't got him. Oh, we got another casualty arriving just around the corner from me at the top of the tower. That's Kim from Ryslip. And in Birmingham, hopefully we've got a national costume.
I'll come up.
Who are you, sir?
I am the councillor for Edgbaston, the person who is responsible for motor racing in Birmingham.
Yes. What's your name, sir?
My name is Peter Barwell.
And why are you dressed as an Arab?
Because you asked for a national dress.
Yes, I just wonder why you were inspired by an Arab.
I'm a sales director for a business forms company, PFC Business Forms, who export to the Middle East.
Congratulations, sir. You are the first person to get the maximum number of plugs in on this Christmas Day.
Thank you.
absolutely brilliant. Now, I don't believe this. I've got this earpiece. You see, on Saturdays I don't normally wear it. I've had fried eggs, someone dying at the top of the tower, and now, ladies and gentlemen, Her Majesty the Queen from Windsor. The royal family are coming out from the Christmas Day service at St George's Chapel. And there we can see Her Majesty. And you can see that, unfortunately, the weather has been unkind to us down in the south. The umbrellas are well and truly out. There's the Queen Mother, of course. And the royal family have been for the traditional Christmas service at Windsor at St George's Chapel. If you've just joined us, you're watching the Live Breakfast Show on this Christmas Day, and as you can see on your screen, a lot of dedications running underneath. You can give us a call on 637 7171. 637 7171. More doors are appearing. In Norwich, we've managed to have a door. Who's that in Glasgow?
Hello, it's Dougie North.
Hello, Doug. Whose door is it?
I don't know. Whose door is this?
Stephen Lambie's.
Stephen Lambie's door.
Stephen, where did you get it from?
Where did you nick it from?
My house.
He's nicked it from his front door.
Yeah. I'll tell you what, Doug, we can hear him all right.
Okay, all right, mate.
We've got a Scottish interpreter there. Anyone you want to say hello to, Steve?
What?
Anyone you want to say hello to?
Hi. So my brother and Nicola Morrison was the winch from.
No. Is this Norwich that we've got there? Hello. Yes, hello Norwich. Hello, who brought that door?
Simon Ruffles brought that door.
Yeah, I brought it, I'm afraid.
Where did you get it from, Simon?
Well, it was the old bathroom door, but we've changed it now.
Have you literally unscrewed that off the bathroom?
No, not quite. It was sitting outside the
door. It was it? So you're not going to get into trouble with the folks there?
No, not yet.
Splendid. Those challenges will keep going. Here's our first. You saw the aircraft take off, set off by Merry Christmas in the Isle of Dogs. We have our camera on board. 747. It's the first time there's ever been live pictures from a commercial airliner. And Gary Davis is there. Hello, Gary.
Amazing Christmas party ever. Happy Christmas. We're about to make history even more now, because here they are with the follow-up to a number one hit record called A Good Heart. The whole band's here, all 11 of them. Fergal Sharkey and the band singing You Little Thief.
Completely. That is wonderful, isn't it? Not only a first, it's water, by the way. It's not only a first that we brought you pictures from a commercial airline, that we managed, but Fergal Sharkey managing to sing without moving his lips. That's another absolute first. Poor old Ian, you can't see the monitors, he couldn't see that going on. Okay, we will be bringing you some other great charitable works that are going on this Christmas Day, and very shortly I hope to be able to link up with some people who are going swimming. I'm not quite sure what you're doing on Christmas Day, but I tell you, down here in London, it's jolly cold, and the very notion of going swimming is not at all pleasant indeed. If you want to give us a call, it's 01637 7171, and if you want to take part in our regional challenges, then why not pop along with a fried egg? But don't bother going to Cardiff, because they've got one already. Keith Hatton is there. Hello, Keith.
Hello, Noel.
Who
How
is,
are you?
Who's the owner of the fried egg? Oh, it's salt.
This is Rhys Morgan, and apparently did it for his mum. And I prefer lots of salt with my fried eggs.
Yeah.
So here we go. Shall I taste it?
Yes, please.
I thought you'd say that.
Wanted to make sure people realised we weren't wasting any of this food this morning. So get stuck in there.
Hey, this is not bad, you know.
Is it quite good, Keith?
This is nice. And it's nice and burnt at the bottom, just as I like them.
Well, seeing they've gone to all that trouble, is there anyone they would like to say hello to? And hello to you. Anyone you'd like to wish a Merry Christmas to?
Yeah, I'd like to say hello to all my mates at work, Morgan Movers, Cardiff. No, not really, a very good firm. my mum and dad.
Oh, who's that? Oh, we've got to say hello
my
to
wife,
the little
my
lad.
My brother, and all my friends, yeah.
Anyone else you want to say hello to?
I'd just like to say hello to all my friends. That's
great.
It, really.
All right, super. Thank you very much indeed. Thank you for the fried egg. Now, hopefully, on this telephone, I've got Noel Ahern. Hello, Noel.
Hello, Noel.
Hello, Noel. Two
hello,
Noels.
Noel.
Full
you?
Of Noels.
Merry Christmas.
Now, we have the helicopter on top of you at the moment. You can no doubt hear and see the helicopter.
That's right, yeah.
What are you all doing at Kingston?
Well, we're down here, we're raising money for the Bonnie Aylett Fund and all the functions we've had over the last couple of months, and with this one as well, this is the last one of 85, obviously, we've managed to raise nigh on £20,000 now. We've already bought an intracranial monitoring machine to go to Great Ormond Street Hospital, and now we've got to pay for somebody to run the thing and keep it going. We've had some marvellous sponsorship, Yorkshire Building Society have been super. Anthony Bryant's estates, just no end of people, but excellent, you know. I mean, I think the whole country's been giving money this year anyway, for one thing or another, but amazed.
Somebody's going to get very, very cold this morning. Is it chilly down there?
It's very chilly down here. I see the water is absolutely freezing. They've all been doing deep water training, they tell me, in hot baths. So
who's going in? Who's actually going in the
we've
water?
We've got Big Charlie, he's Snow White, and the Seven Dwarves. We've got the Sutton and Sheen Water Polo team. We've got barmaids. We've got everyone. Everyone really got into the spirit of it.
Right.
Cheerleaders are all wearing their Bonnie Aylett Fun t-shirts.
Are they ready to go, Noel?
They're ready to go. You just give me the nod and
Just wait, because the helicopter is coming round.
Yeah.
And we just want to make sure we got a good picture. I'll just wait for him to come round a little bit more.
Okay.
Now, okay, they can go.
Right. Cheerleaders, count them down. Go.
I suppose anyone I could arrest is hurting back to Kingston.
Oh, I see. They're having a countdown to the moment
That's
of agony,
right.
Are they?
Cheerleaders are away. Here they go. Whee!
Oh,
oh,
dear.
Oh, my God. Look at the dog.
What a ridiculous way to spend.
A crowd of wallies. Beautiful people. Fabulous. Look. Oh, God, it's freezing. Oh, that's great. Super.
Well, that's marvellous.
Can you see it?
Noel, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for joining us on Christmas Day. And when they get out of the water,
yeah.
Do thank them very much for their efforts.
Okay, I will certainly.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, Noel. Thanks. Bye.
Sutton and Sheen Water Polo Club doing their little bit for charity down there. Smitty!
Yay! Here we are.
How are all your maniacs going? Looks like someone's caught fire.
how's Rusper? Are we all still having a Merry Christmas here? Okay, the village of Rusper down in Sussex. We've got everybody lined up here for a few events, and then I shall be nipping off to Wimbledon for this cricket match. But let's get the dizzy race going. Heat two of the dizzy races. Brooms up, please. Up with the brooms they go. Now, you've got to turn around six times when I blow the hooter. Here we go. Hooter. Right, turn around six times. We're going to get into that broom. Try this at home this afternoon if you want to, and run. Wonderful. Go on, you can do it. You can do it. And we've got a winner, the lady, the purple hair is going to win. And she goes through to the finish. Now, let's just update you here on the ice melting that's going on, because here we have Icebo, who's promised to melt this pile of ice by the end of the show. You're not doing very well.
I'm making gradual progress. I've got a de-icer there if necessary, but what I'm hoping to do is have an ice-cold bath at the end.
Really?
This is the main thing, yes.
Right,
as long as I can direct the water, the melted water, into the tank, everything should be all right. We can all relax.
And I hope you enjoy Christmas lunch in the home. Let's move on now to... We've got the man over here who's... What am I doing? So we can get rid of that and the hat as well. Here is our professional wine taster. I'm sorry about this, but it's Christmas morning. This is Jonathan McKenna. How's the punch, Jonathan?
It's absolutely wonderful. I'm just getting warmed up. I'm just about to do my Christmas rendition of Henry the Fifth.
Yeah, well, we'll leave you to entertain the crowd there. And now we've got the welly racers. These are not any old wellies. These are wellies filled with mud. Aren't you glad you're stuck at home this morning and not here in Rusper? Put your wellies on, please. They've got... Look at the mud in these. Right. Into nice ice-cold mud. Get your wellies on. Get set. And go! Come on, welly racers! You can do it! Actually, I think... There's only slightly more mud on the inside of the wellies than there is on the outside. They've had so much rain here overnight. And we got a winner! Jolly good! Right, we've got a winner there in the welly racing. Now, Jeff Stevenson is with us, and he has got some egg throwers. Jeff.
Thank you very much, Mike. Well, welcome to the egg throwing competition. If you've been watching the Late Late Breakfast Show over the last few weeks, you will see we've had an egg throwing competition where the competitors have to throw an egg so far, and a catch has to catch an egg and make sure that the egg doesn't actually fall on the floor. If it does, that's it, they're disqualified. So we've got some teams here. We've got our first team. Who are? Your team are?
The Hayward Team Leos.
From the Hayward Team Leos. And your name is?
Diane.
And the Leos do raise a lot of money for charity, is that right?
Charities of the area.
That's great. Okay, Diane, if you'd like to throw your egg as far as possible, and don't forget, your partner has got to catch the egg, okay? Let's give it a try. Oh, useless. No, didn't do it. Okay, next competitor. Marvellous costume. Your name is?
Michael Hammond.
Michael Hammond from?
Southport Leos.
From Southport Leos. Okay, let's have a go. Come on. We didn't even see the egg. It's she's over. Not to worry. On to the next one. Okay, we've got another team here. This is from Liverpool, is that right?
Yeah.
And your team is the Mersey Eggbeat.
That's it.
And your name?
Tom Gibney.
Tom Gibney from where in Liverpool? From Crosby in Liverpool. Okay, that's lovely. We've got the catchers down there, if you can see them. Look at them. Okay, if you'd like to go. Oh, almost. Okay, you've got another egg. Go for it. Okay, next competitor in, please. Good afternoon. Happy Christmas to see. Your name is?
Paul
Bradshaw. Paul Bradshaw from?
Crosby.
From Crosby. Okay, Paul, go for it. Oh, let's see if we can do it. Really go. Oh, almost. One more, Paul. Okay, we're going back to Mike.
Is coming up soon. Thank you, Jeff Stevenson. With the ice melting, it hasn't melted yet, but it's time for me now to get into our helicopter and head off to another location for a Christmas Day Christmas cricket match. Now, hopefully on the end of this phone, I can get rid of this because I can't take it in the helicopter. On the end of the phone, there should be Noel. Hello.
Hello. Yes, I can hear you. I can hear you just fine.
Brilliant. Let me get rid of the radio microphone, give it to our sound man here, and I can get going for chopper.
I'm so pleased this is working, Mike, because last year...
I know.
I got it all wrong with that CellNet device.
Right, well, I'm up to the chopper. Is it Bobby C?
Yeah.
I can still hear you loud and clear. It's working ever so well.
Jolly good. Well, you know you're not meant to use it when you actually go flying.
Yeah, well, I'll probably cut off before we take off then, won't I?
No, no, you won't.
On the other hand, as it's Christmas, I won't.
I tell you what, it works beautifully up there.
Thank you to everybody at Rusper, by the way, and to our BBC Outside Broadcast team over here. It's been absolutely splendid. Mike Barrett is the captain. As soon as you're set, Mike, we can get up in the air.
Wish him a very happy Christmas from me. I know Mike very well.
And on the ice melting, I could just put you over now to Icebo. You can see he's still struggling with the with the ice. And look at the stock.
There's a nice popular part of the programme there.
That's our professional wine taster just being given some of the rustic, medieval treatment.
Right, now just to recap, where are you on your way to now, Mike? Where are you going?
I'm taking this particular helicopter to Wimbledon Common. If anybody's in that area, come and join us,
yep.
Because we're going to be playing cricket on Wimbledon Common at about 1:05.
Splendid, sir. Okay, we'll be in touch with you in a little while.
Bye!
He's on his way to Wimbledon Common. At Norwich, we have got a Scotsman. We have a Scotsman in Norwich with the ugliest knees that you could ever wish to see. There he is. Carol, who have you got there?
This is Edward.
Hello.
And, Edward's got wonderful knees, as you can see.
Yes.
And, are you Scottish yourself, Ed?
No, my father is.
Does he know you've got this knee?
Yeah, he's over there.
See, he's wearing Dad's kilt, is he?
We've also got a door. Are you interested in that?
Yes, let's have a door in as well.
Right. This is
Tom. Hello. Where did you get your door from?
Off the bedroom.
You got it.
Actually,
got it off the bedroom. I hope he doesn't get into trouble from anybody. I have three people who have just stopped coughing and wheezing next to me. No, they haven't. Put your hand in front of your mouth when you're coughing. I've got Chris and Stuart's time of 4:45 running together. That is absolutely brilliant. That is Guinness have told us they've established that as a new world record for you. So the risk of feeling a little bit like Jimmy Savile. We've only got one of these. We'll get another one made up. We weren't expecting anybody to run as a pair. Yeah. So congratulations to you. And Thomas, you get the silver. You'll be interested in your time, Thomas. You weren't that much out of it. In fact, only 1 second. 4:46. So running up the 816 steps of the telecom tower. At the other end, Mark.
Thanks very much.
Well done, Mark. You were 4:54. By no means a slow time at all. Well done, chaps.
Cheers.
Many congratulations. Thank you very much indeed for doing it, because, as you know, all the money that you raised, excuse me, is all going to help our efforts to raise money for Comic Relief. Just what Comic Relief are doing will be revealed in a little while, and why they are sending so much money to a special camp in the Sudan will also be revealed, because we'll be linking up with our satellite. But right now, a window at the top of the telecom tower. And I do hope that Chaz Greatorex, who's our whirly-wheeler of a week or so ago, who's been trained for weeks and weeks and weeks, I do hope that he is here. Oh, yes. Yes, he is. And what a wonderful way to spend Christmas. Just outside the telecom tower. Now, I'm told that he has been trained exhaustively over the last 10 days or so. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
You can hear me.
Yes.
Jolly good. How are you? You all right?
Fine.
Lovely. Now, what are you going to do? I said, what are you going to do?
Well, I'm going to clean the window. Just the one window, man.
Oh, you're going to clean the window?
That's
fine.
Right.
What was this about you having the biggest radio-controlled helicopter in the world?
Oh, that's right. See it?
Oh, yes, I see.
It's my brand new Christmas present.
Oh, I'll get the... Are you really working that?
Absolutely.
Well, show us. No one will believe you. Go on.
Harry?
Wait, show us.
Okay. Want to go left or right? Left?
Well, back a bit. Make
back
it go backwards.
Oh, yeah.
That's clever.
There you are.
Oh, it's good. Can you make it go forward? Can you make
forward,
it go
forward? Yes, forward, no problem. There you are. Forward now.
I am impressed. I'm very impressed.
What do you reckon? It's a smashing present.
You're very lucky you remember to get batteries for it.
I have to get them before they take us everybody else's shirt.
Tell you something, I can't hear you either. I won't bother dropping a feather. Forget it, Ted Mole. Do you want to finish cleaning the window?
Certainly.
Jolly good. Oh, well, I'll tell you what, Chaz.
Yeah?
We wanted to go to Richmond now.
Richmond?
Yeah.
Which way's Richmond?
That way, right?
Oh, that way.
Could you send it off to Richmond and then finish cleaning the window?
Off you go, then. Off you go to Richmond.
Chaz, anyone you want to say Happy Christmas to while you're hanging about out there?
I think the battery's gone flat on it. Oh, there we are. It's all right. That's good.
And look, he's doing it without you controlling it. Marvellous. The helicopter goes to Richmond. Chaz, Happy Christmas. Happy Christmas to the rest of the family. Telecom tower from the
radio control helicopter there. Now, I was given a dedication to mention, which I do with great pleasure. It's her 21st birthday. A very happy Christmas to Angela Summers. She's a kissogram girl normally, so it's nice to be able to do it the other way around. Angela Summers is in Letchworth, and all family and friends wish you a very happy birthday indeed. Have a look at this. This is a rather special computer. It's special in that there's over 54,000 names inside this computer. Over the last 10 days or so, people have been phoning the numbers that I've been giving out on the Late Late Breakfast show. And we've stored them all in here. What it's meant is that it's already guaranteed from British Telecom £10,000 for our special relief camp. And if I manage to get my act together here, I should be able to bring up the very first draw, which comes up there. And I've done something wrong. So if I go to resume, I should have remembered the code, which is spinning around now. Right, PKM. PKM is what I should have remembered. PKM. Start and that. And you can see I don't do any typing because I haven't got a clue. Somebody tell me where the K is on a... That's it. And then if I press that and that, those two together. Entry not found. Oh, what have I done wrong? Someone tell me what I've done wrong. Do you want me to try it again? I'm happy to do this all day, actually. HRT has come up as the code. Start. One. And HRT. And those two together. Oh, I got it this time. Julie Criddock, who's in Rushton in Northamptonshire. Julie Criddock, Rushton in Northamptonshire. She'll be receiving one of our telecom stockings. It's got a phone in it and all sorts of various goodies. And we've got a marvellous £1,000 star prize, should I be able to program it correctly, because we'll do four more of those draws in a little while. Also, of course, we'll be going live on our satellite link to the Sudan. If you've just joined us on the live breakfast show on this Christmas Day, a very happy Christmas to you. And if you want to give us a call for dedication, 637 7171. But all the money that we're receiving from these calls, all the money that is in that computer, is all going to a particular relief camp in the Sudan to help train relief workers and make their jobs that much easier. Comic Relief is the name of the charity. They are the people who are, throughout next year, getting as much money together for Ethiopia and the Sudan as possible. And here to set the whole thing up and get us underway with a pretty difficult joke is Rowan Atkinson. And Rowan is going to be telling a joke to one of the most difficult and demanding audiences in the world. Michael Grade, controller of BBC One.
The naughty bus. What's red and stands in a corner? The naughty bus.
Come in.
Hello. What's red and stands in a corner?
I don't know. I'll ask my secretary. Roz, what's red and stands in a corner? Ah, thanks very much. Apparently it's a naughty bus.
Is it? All right. Thank you. Thank you very much. It's a naughty bus. Right. Thank you. It's a naughty bus.
Well, we've got another nine of those top comedians who are being faced by the most difficult audiences you could imagine. Rowan Atkinson, what a funny joke to tell to Michael Grade. If you would like to send any money to Comic Relief, their address is 21 Darblay Street, London West 1. Comic Relief, 21 Darblay Street, London West 1. And here is a man who, personally, I think is the funniest human being alive, Billy Connolly. And here's his contribution.
So this is a true story. It's about a friend of mine called Hamish Imlach. And he was asked to do a gig in Scotland, a kind of strange outdoorish gig. And he was driving there in the evening. It started to rain and he was in the car. He thought, oh my God, it's not going to be so good. The rain got even heavier. He thought, oh God, it's going to be hellish. Turned up at the back door of what he thought was the gig. went in, and there was the promoter. Said, right, Hamish, come in, get ready, looking very nervous. And Hamish said, are there many people here? He said, well, you know, not a lot, but it'll get better. Have a drink. So they had a drink. He said, right, out you go and give them pelters. So he got his guitar, they rushed out. There's this ocean of seats and one man, right, sitting in the rain. He's wearing a pack-a-mac and a cloth cap. There's a puddle in his lap, right, his watch. So Hamish tells him a joke and the guy burst out laughing. So he tells him another joke, he's wrong. Having a great time. Rain's battering down. Goes on a few songs, few jokes. Does about 20 minutes and then he says to the fella, excuse me, this is half time and I'm getting in now. I'm going to have a wee drink. Would you like to come in and join me? And the fella said, look, that would be terrific. But it's just one thing. When are you going to finish? Because I have to put all these seats away. Yeah, he said, you know, he'd have to put the chairs away. He was obviously the man who sort of worked there. Ah, forget it.
And if you thought that was a difficult audience to play to, John Cleese has the unenviable task of trying to tell a joke to Mr. Alan Parker.
Now, Alan, this man went to see a psychiatrist. And the man said to the psychiatrist, I've come to see you because I only ever have two types of dreams. And the psychiatrist said, yes, I see. Tell me about the first type of dream. And the man said, well, in the first type of dream, I dream that I am a wigwam. And the psychiatrist said, a wigwam? Yes, I understand. Now tell me about the other type of dream. And the man said, well, in the other type of dream, I dream that I'm a marquee. And the psychiatrist said, aha, the trouble with you is that you are too tense. He got it.
We'll have some more of those in just a second or two. Julie Criddock, the lady whose name came up on the computer draw and stands to get some marvellous prizes. If you're watching right now, Julie, in Rushton, Northamptonshire, please check your phone. Make sure there's nobody on it. We're trying to dial you at the moment because I want to talk to you. I want to wish you a happy Christmas and tell you more about what exactly you've won. I'll also be doing a few more draws in just a second or two. But another one of the comic relief team and a very difficult audience he's got to talk to, I must admit, is Lenny Henry.
My wife is so ugly, she's got a face like a bucket of frogs. I'll tell you how ugly she is. She went to the Chamber of Horrors the other day, and the man on the door said, excuse me, love, could you keep moving? We're trying a stock take. This is how ugly she is, right? At night, peeping Toms come up to the bedroom window and say, excuse me, love, could you draw the curtains?
Yes. Now, why was that so difficult? Why? Well, the audience happened to be his wife, actress Dawn French.
Sorry, I don't understand at all.
What do you mean you don't understand? I mean, that's the jokes. Those are the jokes. That's what comedians do, you know. It's a comedic technique.
So comedians just tell lies then, do they?
No, they don't tell lies. You know, that's an accepted phrase in comedy. You know, my wife is so ugly that. That's what you have to do, apparently.
So they don't tell lies. So you're not lying. You actually think I'm ugly.
I don't think you're ugly. It's just the way you
do. Do you really think I'm ugly?
No, I don't.
No, why don't you go on television then to millions of people and tell them you think I'm ugly?
I don't.
Why don't you?
I don't think... Look, try this. My wife is so nice that when she went into the Chamber of Horrors, the man on the door said, excuse me, love, you can't come in here. You're far too nice and pretty and gorgeous and wonderful and exciting and gorgeous and wonderful.
Yeah, that's better. Mm-hmm. I'll settle for that. Mm-hmm. And I think you'll settle for that. Unless you want to spend Christmas sleeping in the bathtub, darling.
If you would like to pledge any money to Comic Relief, the address once again, Comic Relief, 21 Darblay Street, London, W1. Please don't send it to the BBC. Send it to them. Jasper Carrot will be with us in a while, Tracy Allman as well. And the whole reason why we're launching Comic Relief on this Christmas Day will become very apparent, because we have a television first coming up shortly, the first ever live pictures from that place that we've heard so much about throughout 1985, the Sudan. Now, I do hope that here, in Rushton, Northamptonshire, is Julie. Hello.
Hello.
Were you trying to ring us, Julie?
Yeah.
And we were trying to ring you, so the phone was engaged.
Yeah.
Are you having a nice Christmas day?
Yes, thanks.
Jolly good. Well, you've seen that your name came up out of our computer.
Yeah.
And how old are you, Julie?
12.
You're 12. Well, I have to ask you a question. It's all to do with some gaming lore. I'm not allowed just to pass the prize on. I've got to ask you a skill testing question. Okay?
Yeah.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
What day is it?
Christmas Day.
Well done! Brilliant! Absolutely brilliant. Well, we are aghast here. We are absolutely overawed by that. I can now send you a slimline phone, some champagne, a Christmas pudding, lots of chocolates, some games, some balloons, flags and all sorts of things as well.
Thank you.
Anyone you want to quickly say hello to?
Yeah, I can say hello to my mum and Gail and my family.
Wonderful. Oh, all right, Julie, have a lovely day today.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Over in Belfast in Northern Ireland, we have the biggest door so far. We had our regional challenge of who could turn up at the various camera sites with doors. Who are you?
Me, I'm Andre. Where's the door?
Yes, I didn't catch your name. I'm sorry,
Andrew.
Sir. Andrew. Hello, Andrew.
How are you?
I do hope that's your door and you're not doing a little nicky-poos there.
Well,
Where did you get it from, apart from on a garage?
It's my daddy's door.
Your Barry's door?
My dad.
Your dad's door?
Well, we've been working on it, and I thought, well, I'd just borrow it for the day.
You're fine. It's not an easy job getting a garage door off. How did you do it?
I was sitting there and I threw it on the roof, regular car, and brought it on down.
What a wonderful accident. Merry Christmas to you. Thank you for your door. Well, I hope we can go to Scotland now for a special link-up. Can we go to Scotland? We can. And the significance of this is rather tremendous, because we're about to hand over, in Linlithgow, we are about to hand over the 21 millionth British Telecom phone line. And Doug Strachan of British Telecom is there, and also Douglas Wernham, our BBC chap. Can you hear me all right, Douglas?
I can hear you.
Jolly good. Would you like to introduce the relevant people there, please? And just tell us why this line is being handed over.
Yes, well, this is the 21st millionth connection of telephones in the UK. And we're very pleased that we've connected it to Donaldson School for the Deaf. And today I have with me Mr. Miller, who's the headmaster of Donaldson School. And we are presenting this equipment to him. It's the same as you have there, Noel, for finding the telephone numbers. Anyway, we want to hand this equipment over to them because the school can use this equipment to help the deaf people by typing words to each other.
Wonderful. Marvellous stuff. Doug Strachan, thank you very much indeed for that. Consider it officially handed over. The school has had associations with Alexander Graham Bell in the past, the man who invented the telephone bill. And here's a nice message. I've got to find time to do this. Stephen and Angela Dooley of London say, Noel, please break the news to both sets of grandparents, Marion and Michael Donovan and Emily and Ray Spivey, that they've got twin baby grandchildren boys called Stephen and Sean. Love also to the grandparents and grandchildren, Lisa, Keller and Jackie. So a pair of lovely arrivals. And now, as we go round the country on this Christmas Day, I can take you up to Yorkshire, to Leeds, and another bit of tippling the glasses. Our whirly wheeler up there in Leeds is Maria Everly. Hello, Maria. She's
Hello.
27. She comes from Markfield in Leicestershire, actually. She's a school teacher, and along with her teacher husband, you've raised over £300 for Comic Relief, I believe.
What was that?
It's all right. You pick them up, dear. I'll just do the talk.
Right.
How many do you think you got there?
I'm hoping to be able to stack up about 28.
Keep at it. Somebody's just carried a telephone box past you, but keep at it and see how well you can do. We can go to Manchester now. Manchester, a very happy Christmas Day to you, sir. And that's Dave Smith. Hello, Dave.
Hello, Noel. Now, I hope you're going to have a bit more success than the last time I met you, Dave.
Oh, yes. Do you remember?
I do remember indeed. Do you want to quickly tell people what went wrong?
Well, I was abseiling from the top of Manchester Town Hall Tower.
Yeah.
And dressed as Father Christmas. You were at the bottom, we were going to do a quick change. And halfway down, my beard got stuck in the carabiner, and that was me stuck there for the night.
Because you were meant to be me, weren't you?
That's right, yes.
How tall are you, Dave?
I'm 6'2".
Yeah. It was stretching the imagination anyway. But he got stuck halfway down the... You were up there for about half an hour, weren't you?
Yes.
All right. How many have you got there? You look like you've got the biggest stack we've seen.
Well, I've got about 25.
Good, okay. We'll come back to you and see how well you get on at picking them up. And of course, we'll be announcing before the end of the show, exactly who is the winner. In Birmingham, there's the Pebble Mill crowd. Hello, Birmingham, Merry Christmas. And there's a door at the back, and there's a fried egg, and there's Julia Bridge, who's from Chorley. She's used to things falling out of the sky because she's done 60 parachute jumps. That's right, isn't it?
Yes.
Why do you like parachute jumping?
Well, I've changed now, I'm acolyte now.
Oh, fine, so you don't mind being up those steps?
No.
Do look after those, they're short of money in Pebble Mill. That's the entire canteen's output of glasses you got there.
Okay.
We'll see how well she manages to do. The gentleman who's downstairs is Alan Chester. He's outside the telecom tower, and he's using a novel method here. He's jammed it against the ceiling, as you can see, and he's done well. Now, we might well have a winner there. That is below me here, 620 feet below me at the telecom tower, and he has done that remarkably well. Very good. Well, maybe I shouldn't have said anything after all. To Bristol, to the West Country, and our whirly-wheeler down there is Gillian Lewis of Stapleton. She doesn't like spiders or jellyfish. That's right, isn't it?
Yeah, I'm afraid so.
Now, we've just seen the man downstairs here in London pick up an awful lot. How many have you got?
Well, I've only got about 20 at the moment, but it's tipping down with rain and it's freezing cold, and I hate to think what's going to happen in a minute.
Well, have a go, Gillian. Try picking them up. See if rainwater in them helps. You can commentate, Cliff. Tell us how well she's doing. Oh, that's pretty good going. And with a balloon on the top. A balloon on the top as well. Newcastle, a very Merry Christmas to you. We have a camera in Newcastle. Pop along to it if you wish. Hello, Newcastle. Joseph Gill. All right, Joseph, are you confident that you are going to be our national winner in this competition?
No, we're having wind problems and all.
Well, I don't want to know about that.
No,
have you had your Christmas lunch then?
No, not yet.
But you've still got wind problems, all right. We did actually understand it would be difficult. Sorry, I've just seen there's another front door there.
Yeah.
There's going to be some drafty homes. Now, have a go at it, Joseph. Just see how many you can pick up. Not because I'm biased towards the south, but at the moment, certainly the gentleman downstairs in the foyer appears to be doing the best. And that's not bad. Yeah, and he's done it on one hand. He's done it in very difficult weather conditions. Well done, Joseph. That's marvellous, considering... come on, do the bit we're all waiting for. The bit we love. No? Oh, he's a professional. He's going to stick at it, come what may. Well, there we go, Joseph Gill. I reckon he's probably in second place in our Whirly Wheel Challenge of picking up the glasses. If you want to give us a call, all the dedications being received are going on to CFAX 637 7171 if you want to call it. The telecom tower in London has a lot of functions going on. It doesn't just take telephone calls. It's also a major switching centre for world television. And downstairs, just a few floors below me, we have the switching centre. And then down in the foyer of the telecom tower, a whole bank of television screens. And if our camera just wanders along, you can see what other people are watching on Christmas Day. And you're right. They're probably getting better value for money than that. No, don't be like that. Right, jumbo time. Our link up with the aircraft that's... It must be gone past London by now. It must be going out to Norwich. Do you know where you are, Gary? Gary, hello. Hello, Gary.
Hi, welcome back to the Virgin Atlantic Jumbo. Just about now we're over Swaffham. And before we go any further, I must say thank you very much indeed to the air traffic control and also the military, because they said if we didn't give them a mention, then they'd reroute us. We don't think we want to go to America just yet. We had a couple of technical problems before. Fingers crossed, wind in the right direction. Hopefully no more lightning. We'll be all right now. Will you welcome back Fergal, Sharky and the band and you little thief?
Well, that's something we actually knew would happen. Not there'd be a problem with a music track in the first instance, but the reason that we wanted Fergal singing his record-breaking song earlier on was that the jumbo has now moved out of sight of our transmitter. It has to be pointed directly at our equipment in order to bring you the pictures, but we will link up with it a little bit later on. Moira Finnenberg, hello to you, Moira. She's in Buckhaven in Fife. What she won't know, but I'm now going to tell her, is that the computer here has just spilled out your name, and therefore you're one of our 10 prize winners in our special competition. I'll be making another draw, if I can make the machine work, in just a little while. But I'd like to announce to all friends the engagement of daughter Catherine Summers to Adrian Ford. They were engaged today, says Doreen Summers of Greenway Bishops Lydiard, near Taunton. And they're phoned through on 01 637 7171. And they will all be on CFAX as well. Page, I've forgotten it, 189. Page 189 of CFAX will contain all the dedications that we've received today. Now, one of the other things that's going on downstairs here in the telecom tower is a feature called video conferencing. It gives you the opportunity to talk to friends over in Germany and for them to see you at the same time. And downstairs at the moment, along with a little baby, we've got Corporal Paddy Carson and his wife Carol. There's kids, there's Kerry and Lindsay. And they're linking up with Mrs. Halfyard. And Gina Smith is down there as well. They're doing all that. Kerry. And also Lance Corporal Paul Walker. And Ruth Smith, his fiancée, who's over in Germany, is going to be linking up with Paul's uncle, David Wade, and his son Russell Wade, and Russell's fiancée, Jean Alice. That's video conferencing, and in some respects, that's exactly what I'm going to be doing with the Sudan in just a little while, because for the very first time, we will be having a satellite link with East Africa. And they will be able to see pictures from this country, as well as us see pictures of what they are doing over there. Now, I hope that I can do another draw on this at this moment. SKX. SKX is the code. It's very difficult for somebody like me to work this. KX, 54,000 names in here, and if I've done it right this time, Jane Mansley. Happy Christmas, Jane. Jane Mansley's been drawn out by the computer. She's in Failsworth in Manchester. We will try and get her on the telephone now. Jane, make sure no one touches your telephone. We will dial you. I'll have a little chat with you. And then our super stack of goodies will be on its way to you. Comic relief is our theme of today. I beg your pardon? Say that again. Banner. What do you say, banner? Oh, there's a banner. Fine. Fine. Well, that's... there's the banner over London. I think Michael Hurl's got shares in the banner company. Well, that's interesting, Michael. I really wanted to see that. Can't say that. That is flying around over London at this moment, wishing everyone a very happy Christmas, as indeed I should think Jasper Carrot would like to do. He's got a tricky audience in comic relief as Jasper Carrot.
Final day in the jungle. The combined insect 11 in the red, the elephant team in the blue. All the animals are there, 40,000 watching. Referee comes out, introduces the teams, blows the whistle, and they're off. The elephants are brilliant. They completely overrun the insects. The insects have no chance. Half-time comes, the elephants have scored 42 goals. The insects walk off, apparently unconcerned. The elephants are really excited, whopping down the tee, very confident. Come out for the second half. The insects have made a substitution. They've got rid of the slug at number 9 and they've put in the centipede. The referee blows the whistle. The centipede is brilliant. George Best, he runs amok. He scores 43 goals. Beep! End of the game. The insects have won 43-42. The elephants can't believe it. The crowd are going ecstatic. They're walking off the pitch. The captain of the elephant team walks over to the captain of the insect team and says, "Well done." And the insect says, "Thank you very much." The elephant said, "That centipede's a bit good, isn't he?" The insect said, "Yeah, he's red hot." The elephant said, "Tell me, why didn't you bring him on for the first half?" And the insect said, "Well, it takes him that long to put his boots on." He's a centipede! He's got 100 legs! He's got to put his boots on! Takes him 45 minutes! The first half! these elephants in the jungle playing football, okay? Every single one of these elephants has got enormous, great knockers. Immense ones, you know what I mean? Like the biggest things you've ever seen.
To prove that this is very much a team thing, this comic relief, we're delighted that despite the fact that they are down under in New Zealand at the moment, we now have a joke being told by Mel Smith and Griff Rhys-Jones.
Marvellous over here in New Zealand.
It is, yeah.
Marvellous.
Yeah.
Marvellous.
We love it here.
Yeah, marvellous.
Yeah. Of course, when we were coming over, right, you were supposed to put your watch back, weren't you, they say, on the aeroplane.
Oh, yeah.
Right? Yeah.
What, 12 hours?
Yeah. No, 10 years.
Yeah. Of course, there's been a lot of fuss in New Zealand recently.
Has there,
all
really?
The, well, the French, you know, with all the nuclear testing and all that.
Oh, really? Yeah. I read about that, because they were testing that bomb, and they blew that ship up, didn't they?
That's right.
Yeah.
Well, they found a couple of people who did it, you know.
Oh, did they?
Oh, they put them on trial in New Zealand. Actually.
Oh, really, yeah.
Yeah, they put them on trial, and they gave them 10 years each.
Did they, really? That'll serve them right, won't it?
Yeah.
10 years in New Zealand, eh?
But they're trying their best, and they're doing it all for Comic Relief. And if you feel that you've got a little bit of extra money, you wouldn't mind passing on to Comic Relief and their efforts for everyone in Ethiopia and Sudan. The address is Comic Relief, 21 Darblay Street, London, W1. Here, I hope, I've got Jane Mansley. Hello, Jane.
Hi.
Failsworth in Manchester, that's where you are, isn't it?
That's right, yes.
Merry Christmas to
Merry
you.
Merry Christmas to you.
As I hope you saw, your name came up on the computer.
I know, I can't believe it.
Well, you're going to get a marvellous little stack of goodies, and that'll be coming through just as soon as Christmas is over.
That's great.
Anyone you want to use this opportunity to wish Merry Christmas to?
I'd like to say Merry Christmas to the Mansley family on Riverton Road in Oldham, and to anybody who knows me.
I thought that was just a radio expression, that. Everybody else who knows me. Great talking to you, Jane. Have a marvellous day today.
Thank you.
Okay, bye-bye. Bye. I think there's a danger I might be getting married now, because I've been passed a message that says there's £10 to Comic Relief if Noel asks his girlfriend, Elizabeth Jenkins, will she marry me? Oh, I see. It's Frank Thompson of Crouch End in North London. Right, so Frank says, Elizabeth Jenkins, will you marry him? Please let us know. Phone us, 637-7171, with your reply. We want to know. Around the country, we've got all sorts of maniacs, our whirly-wheelers, who are picking up glasses. Glasgow, let's see how well they're doing. Linlithgow, which is nowhere near Glasgow, I agree, but it's our Glasgow BBC team that are at that site. That looks pretty good going. 32 glasses there in Linlithgow. Marvellous. Where else can we go in the UK and see whether 32 can be beaten? That's great stuff, isn't it? Are you going to be able to pick that up? Or was he merely counting it? Manchester? Yeah. Hello, Manchester. Dave? Dave, do you reckon you can now try and pick that up for us?
Okay, here we go.
Go on, let's see. How many have you got there?
He's got 30.
He's got 30. Well, that means if Linlithgow can actually pick up theirs, they could beat him there. You need a few more, Dave.
I've got more five on. We've got another five on.
Over there at Pebble Mill in Birmingham, how many have you finally managed to get? How many have you managed to get there?
26.
26? Oh, Manchester have just picked up 30. Mind you, that's not bad. he's still in Plymouth. The best dressed one we got, Monty Pugh, 25-year-old engine technician with the RAF. He's
keep dropping it now.
have you tried picking them up and you keep dropping them?
It's the BBC trays I've got.
What? here's the maniac in Belfast. Hello, I've forgotten your name. Who are you?
My name's Gerard.
Oh, yes, that's right. You're from Derry, aren't you, Gerard?
We were just walking in the air.
Yes, I think you've definitely been on the pop today.
Yeah,
how many have you got there?
We used most of the glasses already.
How many have you got there?
We have 12 heavy trays.
Gerard, listen to my words.
Yeah.
How many glasses have you got there?
48 glasses.
48. If you can pick that up, you will be our winner. If you can pick it up.
No problem.
We'll come back to confident gentlemen in a while. Leeds have got quite a few. Oh, that is a good stack in Leeds. But it's the number that's important. Leeds, how many have you got there?
We've got 26 trays, that's over 100 glasses.
Maria Everleigh is going to pick up 100 glasses?
Yes.
Well, are you ready to do it now?
I'm ready.
Go on, well, let's see this attempt, because if you can do it, Maria, you will undoubtedly be our winner. I haven't seen anyone who's managed that many. You've got to do it.
There it is.
That's it! She's taken a handle! It's a fix, they're glued. They've got to be glued. They look as if they are glued. I think that's the winner in Leeds, over 100 glasses. Hello, Smitty.
Ah!
Hello.
Yeah, I was getting so wrapped up in that competition. I'm in Wimbledon Common, and you can see the picture there.
Yep.
That is from the Helly Telly. I'm standing down here with my little Watchman television set, watching everything going on. We're playing cricket down here. I've got the Whelan family with me. I'm the one in the white suit doing that from side to side. Can you see me?
Yes, we can.
Because I can't see it now. My picture's gone off. But I've got Jane Whelan with me. Jane, the Whelan family. Do you do this every year?
Yes, every year. For about the last 15 years at least.
Why?
Because when we were... Here's the ball!
Ow!
When we were very small, my mother wanted to get rid of us for a bit of peace and quiet to cook for dinner. So she booted us all out with my dad.
Oh, I think that's my middle wicket bowled out. Well, but now, over here, we've also got... If you can... No?
Yeah, but sorry, I lost what you said then.
We got the plum... What do you call the plum forest oglers?
Plum forest oglers.
What do you do?
We do traditional dances from the plum forest. Which is on the borders of England and Wales, around about mid Wales.
But will you do one now?
We'll do one.
God, they all stink of real ale now. They all stink of it.
I wish I did.
Quick, do a dance. Do a dance, because the Helly Telly's watching you.
What did they say it's called, Smitty?
It's called Plum Forest Ogling, and they put haddock fillets on the ground.
Yeah.
And then they dance around them while a man plays an accordion.
Oh, what a mature way to spend Christmas Day.
It is, isn't it? Now, I've just got to sing as my pilot. Mike!
Now, where are you going next?
We're just winding up the old holly chopper.
Yeah.
And I'm going to be flying back into London to come and visit you at the Tower.
Good. Look forward to seeing you up here for a quick drinky poo.
Oh, yes. All right, Smitty.
All right, bye.
See you soon.
As he leaps in the machine to leap off. We have now got that broadcasting first that I mentioned at the beginning of the programme. I can't help it. I'm as excited as anything. Last year, we touched a lot of hearts when we linked up live with the Falkland Islands. That, in some respects, was a little bit easier because, of course, it's fairly simple to move large equipment into place like the Falklands when there were so many forces services available. However, this year we're linking up with relief workers in the Sudan, and we've had to take a satellite dish to the most remote place that anyone has ever moved such a large piece of equipment. How it got there is in itself an interesting story. This piece of film has just arrived here. I've not had the opportunity to see it, but if we could run it, there is the dish that was loaded onto a Belfast, which was chartered for us by Vaco Trucks. Belfast is one of only two planes in the world that is big enough to take a dish of this size. Not only does the dish go out there, but we've actually moved part of a satellite to make this broadcasting history. That is a big plane by anybody's standards, that Belfast. It almost looks as if it couldn't get off the ground, but it did, as you can see, on its way to the Sudan. Meanwhile, the 11-strong crew that we were getting out there, and I'd like to thank all the volunteers for the Beeb who've given up their Christmas. They were going courtesy of British Airways, and they took with them Christmas hampers for the camp by way of hand luggage. This, I imagine, is Khartoum, which is the capital of Sudan, of course. There's a BBC lorry, which normally doesn't go very much further north than Birmingham. And the officers have saved the children are in the background there. They run the camp from there, and they met a number of pleasant people who were very anxious to help them. This is the convoy setting off on its journey. It's worth remembering the Sudan is the size of the whole of Europe, and the dish only had to go 250 miles. However, of the 250 miles, only 150 miles are on tarmac. The convoy had to pass the Nile and then on into the country. It really does look like something out of Lawrence of Arabia. Although, of course, Lawrence didn't have any satellites at his disposal. The camels are still there. And everything went quite well until they got to this place, Jadarif. It's the last major town on the road. The houses we will see are called Tukuls, and we will see some of these houses if we manage to get this live link up. Now, the people in this area, of course, have got used to seeing
relief workers and seeing trucks coming through, and they really gave our team a very warm welcome indeed. They are laughing and joking at what we still find a very funny sight in this country, called a BBC engineer. Now, unfortunately, Jadarov is also the place where the road runs out, and this is where somebody had a great idea, and hopefully the idea has really worked. The reason they're looking with so much interest is they thought of putting the satellite dish onto a waterbed, hoping that it would buffer some of the bumps and undulations of the road, and that's what's going on there. It's being craned onto a truck, and on that truck is a waterbed, and there they are on their way, praying it would work, no doubt. The road from that point on really does deteriorate like mad. You can see that when we talk about trucks to do this job, they have to be incredibly large and very robust and strong, and they also have to have a pretty good lookout for hazards such as that. The people in the area are very friendly indeed, although of course rather surprised to see such an unusual shape passing through. There it is on its way, the last part, and they got through to the village. I assume this is the village. They're drinking tea. That really, what a great shot. I mean, that says what it's all about. Remember, it's not just the satellite dish going out there and our BBC equipment. We were hitching a ride. Some much-needed supplies for the relief workers were also on their way. 4,000 miles, that dish travelled to the Sudan. And although they are fairly robust, those items, they're not made for that kind of treatment. And it is with some trepidation that all of us here at the BBC are waiting to find out whether that convoy have been able to do the goods for us. I hope that we can now have a magic moment of broadcasting history and link up with the Sudan. Yes. Yes, hello. Merry Christmas. Hello, Helen.
Hello,
Control. Control yourselves.
It's worked. It's worked.
It has worked. I ought to explain that Helen Fielding, the lady in the middle holding the microphone there, you've been working on our show for a number of years and you've given up your Christmas, haven't you, to go out there. What's it like?
I have no.
What's it like out there, Helen?
I just can't describe it. It's completely extraordinary to be sitting in the baking heat in the middle of Africa watching the Late Late Breakfast Show and talking to you. It's just extraordinary.
Well, I've got all sorts of tingles going up and down my spine here. It's wonderful to be able to talk to you. And obviously the people around you are very important people indeed. We'll talk to them in just a moment. We've got some nice surprises and some nice reunions lined up. But tell me a little bit about this place. Can you try and describe the camp? I mean, it looks like there's a full-blown desert behind you.
Yes, if you look just behind me, you can see some white tents against the horizon.
And a camel. That's I can see a camel.
And a camel. And a camel. Of course, this is Africa, though.
Fair dues. So the camp is over there, but why aren't you actually in the camp at the moment?
Well, where we're sitting at the moment is the compound where the relief workers live. Let me introduce the people I'm with before we do anything else. They're really lovely people, and we're having such a nice Christmas, and we've got such a lovely crew.
Good.
This is Helen Derbyshire, who's going to be talking to her mum. And this is Jim, who's the camp administrator, who's also going to be talking to his mum.
Hello, Noel.
Hello, Jim. Tell me a little bit about the camp in terms of your job. What goes on there?
In the camps, well, we run feeding programmes. There are two sites. There's one that you can see behind us here, and there's another site about 7 kilometres north of here. Mm-hmm. And we run hospitals in each site, feeding programmes, TB programmes, and home visiting programmes in both sites.
Yeah.
And my job is just to administer all of that.
I see. We've obviously received the pictures that you sent to us on film of the journey, but I believe that you've got a facility there that you could play as a tape, so we could see around the camp. Is that right?
That's right, yes, we have a tape here.
Well, could we
Can
see
I
that?
Just say here, Noel, that the really wonderful thing about the camp here is that it's such a success story. The site's opened up about a year ago, and they're full of refugees from Ethiopia, Tigray, to be precise, which is a region of Ethiopia. And when they started, about 90 people a day were sometimes dying, whereas now the death rate's down to...
It's about 25 a month, I should say.
And it's full of happy children, life is starting up again, they're well fed, it's organised. And the very good thing is that the people here are passing on their knowledge to the Tigrayan refugees, so that the refugees can help themselves. Yeah. And not relying totally on the relief workers. But let Jim talk to you, and we'll show you the film.
Lovely. If you could take us on a bit of a guided tour, Jim, of your domain.
Okay, guided tour of Safar coming up.
So this is
that's the site that you can see behind us, which we call the old site. These houses are made. They're wooden framed houses, covered in plastic, which was put there for the wet season. You can see the river Atbara, behind the camp. This is
those are the
old site tents, and that is the waterworks where we pump the water up from the river.
Now, is that a problem, Jim? Is it a great problem getting hold of fresh water?
At the moment, no. During the dry season, the river does dry up. There's Richard there, who he actually got out of bed that morning to go and dig a hole.
And what's going on here?
Help the aged hospital there. This is Jane. She's just come from UCH and she's actually got a neonate in her arms there. A little tiny baby.
This baby was born at one kilogram, it's now 2 kilograms, so...
That's me! In my hospital! Sodkan there had had a snake bite and her leg had sort of blown right up and she had her 5 units of blood. There's Linda and Pam. With the traditional birth attendants. Look, they're putting on a play. This is how they do the teaching. They do little plays all the time. They're brilliant. Let's try and hit a fetal heart.
That's the home visitor program, isn't it?
Oh, yes, that's Mary. Mary there.
Mary doesn't look very happy.
Very serious job.
Yes, on that subject, Jim, do you have any problems keeping up morale amongst the relief workers?
Amongst us, no, none at all. Especially now that the BBC are here, it's been a real relief for us, actually. The crew have all been marvellous. Helen's been marvellous, doing the work of 4 people. We're really grateful to everybody for coming. And for fitting in so well.
I think that's a nice point to make, Jim, because we might well be considered to be getting in the way, but we certainly hope we're showing a nice optimistic picture of the way in which the work is now being started.
The little children dancing in the feeding centres. It's absolutely brilliant, and they do this shoulder shaking business. It's absolutely marvellous.
It is wonderful to see life sort of starting up again in the camp. The children, a few months ago, you were saying they were sort of listless and ill, but now you go into the feeding centres and it's all dancing and singing and excitement. And the children are happy, really, now, aren't they?
Absolutely.
I think you can see here just very happy, healthy children who 6 months ago were malnourished and in a totally different state. It should be emphasised that this is thanks to all of the people who gave us money to do this.
And the point is that the money does work. If you send money, it achieves results.
Tremendous. Well, as you know, Helen, Comic Relief is going to be sending an awful lot of money out there to the camp. Let's do a nice little link-up now, what all this is about. Helen, we've got some friends of yours up in Norwich. Mr and Mrs Morley.
Oh,
and right, now who can you see there, Helen? Tell us who your family are.
It's my goddaughter, Wade.
Well, they can see you.
My mother.
Get the tissue.
I got tissue.
And with the
oh dear.
That's better. That's a nice touch. We can see you both on our screens as well. Would the people in Norwich like to pass a message quickly, please?
Hello, Helen. Happy Christmas.
What a contrast between.
She's not talking.
Yes, she is. Yes, she is.
What a contrast between the two pictures there, the rain of Norwich and the sun of the Sudan. And I believe, Jim, that we can link up in Bristol for you.
She's not talking, is she?
With
yes, I am.
Mrs. Atkinson and Stephen. Can we have our Bristol picture?
Hello.
There it is. Jim, would you like to say something to Bristol?
Where are they? Oh, there you are. Hello, how are you, Stephen? Mum.
Very well.
Hello. You look great. It's lovely to see you on TV.
Great.
Oh, you look, you
Stephen,
like
Stephen,
Helen.
Can you see a compass?
Yeah, I thought you'd find that useful.
Yeah, I can, actually, I can find my way to work now. It's quite handy.
Yeah. Hey, Helen. Helen, thank you very much for taking James's Christmas present.
Oh, that's all right.
James,
great
have you
pleasure.
Opened it yet?
Yeah, I have. Thanks very much. I haven't opened it yet, but I've opened it.
May I quickly say that Philippa and David send their love.
Yeah.
I wish they were here too. And we're looking forward to seeing you in March, I think.
Yeah.
All right, thank you.
Okay, thanks.
Jim, we can also link for you, not just with Bristol, but sitting next to me here in London, we've got three of your friends. Who are you, madam?
Fiona McIntosh.
And how do you know? How do you know him, then?
Martin and I used to live in the same house in Oxford when we were students at Oxford College.
Right, I'd like to wish him a Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas,
you're looking
James.
Lovely, Fiona.
Sorry?
You're looking great.
Thank
How
you.
Are you.
And you too. You look a lot browner than I do.
And Martin and Matthew here as well. What's your connection with Jim?
Well, I saw him when he was about 7 climbing off a school bus in Broad Main.
So you've been friends for a long time?
Yeah, I think he's still got the same pair of socks, actually. He's taken them out there.
All right, wish him a Merry Christmas.
Happy Christmas, James.
Yeah, Happy Christmas.
Can you see us all right?
All right, Helen. Helen, as you know, we're very tight for time on this satellite link. We will come back in just a little while and we'll meet some more of the people there and we will link up with other parts of the UK. But great to see you. Great to
it's
see
really
you.
It's really nice to talk to you.
All right, don't go anywhere. We'll be back in just a little
no,
while.
We won't go away. We won't go away. Happy Christmas.
You're watching the live Christmas breakfast show on BBC Television. My watch says it's about 27 minutes past one. I hope you're having a marvellous Christmas day. I certainly am. We've got all sorts of daft things still to come. We'll be going back to Sudan in just a little while. Comic Relief is providing all sorts of laughs for us. And the lady who now has to entertain some people at Battersea Dogs Home is Tracy Allman.
My kind of town, Battersea is. My kind of town. Hello, it's lovely to be here in Battersea. I always love coming to Battersea. You're fabulous audiences. You really are. Hello, sweetheart. Are you married to him? Are you? Lovely. Little joke for you. It'll make you laugh. It'll make you laugh. It's a really, really rich guy. A really rich guy. You listen to me. You listen. And he's got an only son. And he loves this boy like crazy. He's fantastic. He's fantastic, this son. Right. Got one son. And every year, I mean, the guy's a multimillionaire. The kid could have whatever he wanted. And every year on his birthday, right, he says, what do you want, son? He says, Daddy, I want a pink ping pong ball. And he says, you can have anything you want. He says, I just want a pink ping pong ball. So, come here, listen. So, he grows up and, like, he gets to 18. He says, son, what do you want? Your own woman, your own yacht, your own hotel, your own Lamborghini. He said, no, Daddy, I just want a pink ping pong ball. Yes. A pink ping pong ball. So, anyway, this is the tragic part. Right, the guy gets a bit older. The son has a terrible accident. He's literally, I mean, he's got a few, you know, minutes left. The dad dashes to his bedside. Yeah? The dad dashes to his bedside and says, son, can you tell me one thing before it's too late? Why did you always want, stop it, a pink ping pong ball? And the son goes, because. That's it.
Did you get that? You're stupid.
Well, you're thick, Lily.
No, I didn't get it either. But I hope you'll get the message. Comic Relief, it's 21 Darblay Street, London W1, if you feel like sending a little bit of money. You've now seen the sort of people who would very much like to receive your money. The relief workers. That's what Comic Relief is all about. They are helping relief workers, training nurses, mechanics, technicians, that sort of thing. And now, Rick Mayle and Aid Edmondson. If you thought the last one was daft, have a look at this one.
Good morning, Britta!
And a Merry Christmas to one and all!
And here is our joke for Christmas! Sir Adrian? And the audience we have decided to tell this joke to is definitely the most difficult audience in the world. Sir Adrian, could you bring in the audience, please?
Why, certainly. Here he is, a Chinese mountain ant in a matchbox.
Sounds easy. Not when you realise that this ant is, in fact, deaf.
Deaf!
Which is why we have chosen a visual joke. Sir Adrian, could you warm up the audience, please?
Certainly. Okay, simmer down. Right, he's ready.
Right, do the joke. Can you hear him laughing? And if you think that was funny, cop this for a laugh.
Merry Christmas!
Well, it's Rick Mail and Aid Edmondson, all part of the comic relief team. But there's even more of that to come in a while. But now, high above us, well, somewhere high above the United Kingdom, is our jumbo jet with the crankies on board. Hello!
Hi! We're having a great time up here!
Do you know where you are?
Belgian Atlantic, it's time to play Take a Letter. We've got Paul Senior
and Paul King. Junior, so would you like to come up here?
Come up on here.
We've got this is Paul Junior.
Paul Junior, Paul Senior. Right. You've got 1 minute, 45 seconds to see how high a score you can get.
Ready?
So Paul, take a letter. It's a letter W. It's a question. How many in a dozen?
No.
Well, that's it. Paul Senior, take a letter.
E.
E. Oh, it's a stunt. It's a stunt. Get the apple out of the tree.
Oh, there we are. Go on, Paul.
Go on, Paul. Take a letter. And it's a letter O. It's another question. Who is the lead singer with King? Paul King. Take a letter. It's a letter Y. It's a stunt.
Okay.
Put on the antlers here.
Oh. I can't make it.
Right, and the cook.
And the goat, and the goat.
Quick. Paul Junior, take a letter. And it's an S. It's a question. What date is it today? What date?
Oh, the 25th.
Paul Junior, take a letter.
Yay!
It's another stunt.
Here you are.
Get the orange out of the Rice Krispies. Name the Queen's husband. It's O. Put on the mask. Get the mask.
Score? Five!
I think it was six!
Yes,
it was six! Oh, well.
Big round of applause!
And now we've got the next couple. Gary Davis!
Sorry, Gary!
That's how they are.
And Paula Ann!
Looks like the sort of jumbo jet I go on. I hope here we've got some people who are having a party down in Raynes Park in London.
Hello,
can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
Who am I talking to?
It's Paulette here.
Hello, Paulette.
Hello.
Well, we have our helicopter hovering over the top. I can see a gentleman juggling.
That's right. Well, I think it's a girl, actually. She's just very butch.
I'm terribly sorry. From this distance, I think I'm permitted to make the mistake. That's lovely. It's Pepys Road, is it?
That's right, Pepys Road.
Pepys Road is wishing us a very Merry Christmas.
Absolutely.
You've got quite a crowd down there.
You can see them all. They're all drunk. It's disgusting. I didn't know we had so many neighbours. I don't think we will after this.
Is everybody getting on in a nice, friendly way, though?
Oh, it's wonderful. God knows how we're going to get rid of them.
Wonderful. Well, thanks for letting us drop in on your party.
That's all right.
All right, Paulette. A Merry Christmas to you.
Merry Christmas to you, too.
Bye.
Bye.
Now that's Raynes Park, which is sort of that away from the telecom tower, an awful long way that away. It's the place that you can see on your screens right now, the Sudan, where Helen Fielding is our representative there. And hope, who have you got with you now, Helen? Who have you got with you now, Helen?
We've got everybody under the sun, it seems, at the moment. We're standing in the compound where the Save the Children workers live. I don't know if you can see, there's the tuckles where everyone sleeps. And all the relief workers in the area have come over to see us today. We've got the Help the Aged people here. They work in Safawa Camp as well, and they live in the compound next door. It's quite strange that they've just saved the children and Help the Aged, so you say, don't you? You become an old age pension at 15. We've got the girl nurses from Ireland.
Hello.
And they're from Wad Cowley Camp, which it...
Which part of Ireland did you say they were from?
Dublin.
Well,
Because you know these pictures are being seen in error, so that you will be able to...
Look, you see her, Alex.
Sorry, Helen, continue.
Well, the other people who make a lot of noise at the back are the Save the Children workers from Wad Cowley Camp, which is about...
OK, have you got Richard... Is that Richard Taylor next to you?
Settle down now, please.
Is that Richard Taylor next to you, Helen?
Sorry?
Is that Richard Taylor next to you?
It is Richard Taylor, yes.
Hello, Noel, how are you? Happy Christmas.
Same to you, Richard. Very nice to be able to link up with you. And hopefully we can link up with the site where Mike Smith was earlier, Rusper. Can we have some pictures from Rusper?
Yes, you must wait.
And you tell us, Richard, tell us all the way from the Sudan, who are those people standing down there in Sussex?
That's my brother with the cool-looking red scarf on the left. And then Mum on the right, followed by Mike Fancourt. He's been wearing that jacket for about 4 years now. And Doss, the last one on the right there, he's lost about 3 stones since I last saw him.
Now, would you
How
like...
How are you?
We're fine.
Oh, dog, I missed out. Dog, yes, dog, dog, don't hide behind me, brother. Come on, come out. Dog, I shared a flat in London with Dog there. A second from the left.
Now, you have your shirt, Rich.
Helen, I've got a whole load of people who have been moved in next to me here in the tower, and hopefully somebody out there will be able to recognise these faces. Can we have a few names, quick introductions along here?
Hello, I'm Lionel Scott. Pamela just there.
Yeah.
Mark Whitby. Alison
Hello,
Scott.
Alex.
Hello, Alex.
See you.
Huh? Hello. Hello, Auntie Pam.
Hi there, look at her.
Hello, Auntie Pam. Hello, Auntie Pam.
Alex, stop eating our microphone, will you, please? You've just deafened an engineer. Oh, it's my auntie, is it?
How are you?
I'm fine. A bit warm.
Yeah, it's all right.
How about you?
We're quite hot here, too.
What's the food like, Pam?
Well, I've got a little bit of it here.
What
have
you got? Oh.
What advertising?
That's not... You have to eat it with your fingers as well.
What exactly is it?
What is it?
Well, it's beans.
Beans. Beans, fine,
beans,
okay.
Or something else, I'm not sure.
Is Jane Robertson there, please?
Yes, Jane's here too.
Hello, Jane. We're linking you up 4,000 miles to some people down in Sussex. There's a family shot for you.
Hello, Jane.
Hello.
Hi, Mum.
Hi, Mary.
We're all here.
Hi, Russell.
Here.
Say hello. Give me a wave.
Could somebody down there in Sussex just quickly introduce everybody so the rest of Britain knows who we're looking at?
Yes. I'm her sister, Mary.
Yeah.
I'm Mother. My husband, my little boy Russell. This is Dad, and my little boy Christopher.
Oh, Christopher, he's grown! My God.
But he's bound to.
Jane, what do you use the camel for?
Water. They bring water to the hospital and the feeding centre.
How much does it hold?
Oh God!
I would ask.
We've got
like
a camel over here. Why don't bring the camel round? Can you bring the camel round?
I'd be careful if I were you, Helen. They do have vile habits, don't they?
What about the other relief agencies, Jane? Who else have you got out there? Are you all together?
Sorry?
The other relief agencies, do you all live and work together?
So, yes, most of the time, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Helen, we'll come back to you in a little while. We've still got some more people and some more surprises, but... Obviously, it's a great opportunity for everybody just to see a face. It's a silly little chat, but it's nice to see smiling faces at Christmas.
That's it. It is just lovely to do that. Okay, we'll see you in a while, Noel.
Yeah.
Do come back, won't you?
We will. We'll be back with you in just a little while, but from
right.
Sudan down to Richmond Green, where the helicopter is now hovering. And they are carrying on with the most peculiar pastime down there in Richmond Green. I think they're doing a little bit of sponge throwing. And, hello? Hello? Who can I talk to there? Would someone like to tell me which of these two telephones is likely to have someone... Oh, I'm glad you've arrived. I'm glad you've arrived. It's all going to worms, here. hello. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Nice to be sitting beside you.
It's nice to have somebody else help me through the chaos. I hope you're on my side.
Don't think anyone else is. Hello, Rich McGreen. Rupert!
No, this is Roy Marshall Rains Park.
Hello, Roy, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you. How are you?
I'm all right. What are you doing in Rains Park?
Well, the helicopter's just been over.
Yes. Well, I didn't want to talk to you.
Oh, well, okay. Well, you can talk to somebody else then.
Merry Christmas to you, anyway.
Merry Christmas to you all, too.
Nice to talk to you.
Great.
If there is somebody tearing their hair out on Richmond Green, they can no doubt see the helicopter, and we can't talk to them. I've just heard something exciting.
Scotland.
Biggest door in the world.
I heard that as well. Oh, look at
biggest door
that
in
one.
The world. There it is. That is the winner of our regional challenge to come up with a door while we're on the air.
Green door.
Who's behind the door? Whose door? Whose door is that? Come on, let's find out whose door it is.
As far as we know, it's Jamie's door.
Jamie's door.
Where did we get it from?
From a barn.
It's a barn door. It's a barn. But it's not Jamie's door.
We'll give you some good Christmas.
Motorists are asked to look for escaped animals in Scotland.
We'll give you some good goodies for that. Thank you, Scotland. Thank you, guys, for bothering to bring that along. They're mad. Of course, mind you, I think we're pretty mad to be doing this.
I think we are fairly lunatic. There's something strange going on in Plymouth.
Is there?
Have you seen Plymouth?
No.
Have a look at Plymouth. What look at the state of that lot.
Oh, no. Oh, pouring with rain down here, Noel.
Yeah, it's raining in most of the UK at the moment, I think, Plymouth.
Yes, I'm afraid we've abandoned most of our people. They've gone home for their Christmas lunches. But we've collected some rainwater for you.
Thank you very much indeed. Have you enjoyed yourself, Monty? Now, of course, Rowan Atkinson has been one of the many comedians who's been helping with comic relief. I'm delighted to say that on a day of live link-ups, I believe we can actually go over to Rowan Atkinson's home live,
yeah.
Can't we? And Rowan can give us a seasonal greeting. Hello.
Hi, Rowan.
Hello. Hello, Rowan.
Rowan, can you...
Hello, Rowan. Rowan? Rowan.
It's a shame to get this far and then...
Hello.
Hello? Rowan, yes.
Sorry?
Hello, Rowan. Hello, Cooey.
Hello, Noel.
Hi.
Hello, Mike.
Hi.
And a very Merry Christmas to the pair of you.
Thank you very much indeed. Very kind.
I wish my stocking had been crammed half as full as your ship.
Well, that's us. Value for money, eh?
Well,
value for money.
Packed it in.
And now, through the miracle of live television, I would like to wish everyone at home a very happy Christmas too. But more than that, through another miracle, I would like to introduce you to a very special guest who I have here at home with me at the moment.
Is he famous?
Well, I'm a tremendous admirer of his, and I think that you, Mike, yeah, are a very big fan indeed.
Bruce Springsteen.
Prince Charles?
No.
Joan Collins.
Barry McGuigan? Barry.
Ladies and gentlemen, spending Christmas Day with me, Mike Smith.
Hello, Noel.
Mike.
Hi.
How are you?
Well, I'm just fine. I mean, with Ron and Rowan here, we're just, you know, getting into the spirit of the occasion, having a very good time. Oh, can I just say,
yes,
thank you very much, Mike, for standing in for me today, because at one point I thought I'd have to do the whole show by myself.
Yeah, well, that's my pleasure. No problem.
Hang about. This isn't live.
It is live. Let's pinch myself, it's live. Look, just because you can't be in two places
at once.
Yeah,
no, be quiet for a minute, will you? I want to talk to myself for a bit.
It's not...
Now, listen, Mike.
Yes, look, yes. Sorry, Mike's had just a little bit too much. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the Late Late Breakfast Show very much indeed for all the help with the launch of Comic Relief. I'd like to thank you all at home for your contributions and for your telephone calls. Do keep your eyes open for us in the new year. We'll have an album and a book and a show on show somewhere in the new year. And until then, I'd just like to wish everyone a very, very Merry Christmas.
Yeah, before we go, one more, if you don't mind, one more Christmas joke.
Oh, no.
Mike?
Yeah?
Mike, this is for you. Listen.
Yeah.
What sort of spies do you find around Christmas time?
Mint spies.
You knew it?
Well, yeah, of course I did.
I suppose you would, really.
Yeah.
Anyway, where'd you get that outfit from?
I got this yesterday.
Well, it's horrible. Why don't you talk to me first? It's revolting.
It's not.
It is.
It isn't.
It's terrible.
Look, just shush. Thank you, and goodbye.
Well, goodbye.
One of us is going mad, you know.
So are about 12 million others.
And I'm certain it's me. Incidentally, while you're clattering around with all this gear on, yes, we've had a number of people who have been phoning us and saying that they would like to pledge money for Comic Relief for my pullover, and no doubt your outfit would go down a storm.
Should I take it off now?
What have you got under there?
My thermal vest.
637 7171. 01637 7171. £25 is the top bid for this. It's been made by a lovely lady in London for me.
Look, and, I've forgotten to put a bra on again.
State of his body, awful. If you think that you could come up with a better offer for comic relief, then we would love to hear from you. Dear me. You've been having a bit of a heat up in there, haven't you?
And, I brought you a present back.
Have you? Hang on, I'm going to go to the suit. Oh, no, look. Don't, not yet. Not yet. Not yet. Dear me. Well, Kenny Everett show last night. Sudan, hello again. Hello, Helen.
Hello.
You're in the safest place, Helen. Smitty's having one of his attacks.
Not one of those.
Who have you got there for us?
Well, I've got Richard Young here.
Yeah.
Who wants to talk to Wendy.
Big Wendy, did he say?
Is Big Wendy there?
Yes, she's here.
Hello, Wendy.
Hello, Richard.
God, you look good enough to eat.
Richard, I don't want to worry you too much. She keeps grabbing my knee here.
Does she?
I think she.
That's all.
I think she misses you.
Is her mother? Is your mum there?
She is, but she's not here. She's downstairs.
She's sober still?
Yes, just about. What have you got on, Richard?
What have I got to clothes, Wendy?
It's not your normal clothes, surely.
Send underwear out quick.
I've only got the shoelaces.
Oh. I want to introduce you to some people I work with. Goal nurses here. There's one here, Rosie, Frida, Moran and Anne. And they're all, I've invited them all to our wedding in June.
Speechless. Absolutely speechless.
When is it, Richard?
When? In June. Didn't you get my letter?
No.
Hasn't he been putting it off for rather a long time?
Well, he has a little bit, but I haven't heard a thing about him.
Yes, sorry.
So, was that,
Helen.
Is he all right, Helen? He seems to have had an attack. Get your hand off me knee. I'll be in trouble.
Richard, when is this?
Mid-15th, I think.
Yeah, she wants to know this year or next year or when?
Or leap year.
When's next year?
And Helen, you've also got somebody else that we're going to do a link with Bristol, I believe.
That's right, yes. We've got Derek here. Derek Probert is the engineer from Save the Children Fund who really made this possible. He got the dish on the lorry and got it out here, so well done, Derek.
Derek, are you...
Hello, Simon.
Oh, hang on. There he is. We've got him up now. Can you see him?
Hello, Simon. How are you?
All right, thank you.
Are you still playing football?
Yeah.
Have you had any snow to stop you playing this time?
No.
Well done, keep playing and keep practicing.
Simon?
Yeah?
You don't seem very happy to be having a look at him. You love him really, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, more, oh, yeah. Derek, was it really your idea about the waterbed that managed to get the dish out there safely?
Well, John and I sort of just... discussed it, the idea developed one night over a cup of tea, and anyway, it worked, Noel. We've got it here, and I'm very pleased for everybody.
Yes, and I tell you, we are very, very grateful. It's been an absolutely magic link-up. Can you hand the microphone back to Helen? I'd just like to say a few other words. Helen, is there anybody else that you feel at this moment that we ought to just quickly try and fit in?
Well, yes. What we want to say, really, before we go, is that the camp... that you've seen here and that the camp the people here work in is a real success story. But there's other parts of the world and other parts of Sudan where money's really still needed. Chris here is the field director for the whole of the Sudan, and he just wants to say a few words about that.
Yes, there is a continuing problem in the West. The harvest has failed there. People there are living a pretty grim life with the desert advancing on them, the forest disappearing, and in many places the forest's entirely dead for many miles. It's a tough life out there. People are racked by malaria and malnutrition, and it's difficult to survive. And over the past few years, rainfall has dropped further and further, killed off animals, put people into debt, and it's really pushed many thousands of people over the edge. Save the Children Fund is working with about 3 million people in Darfur, and the problem will continue this coming year.
So what we're really saying is please keep sending the money, really, aren't we? It's still needed.
Certainly, yes. The most positive thing to come out of this, I think, has been the enormous response from people in Britain, and the emergence of Comet Relief is a great benefit there, and we hope that they We'll be able to link up with the governments, because governments have not always been as helpful as they might have been in coming up with aid. But if the two can work together, then I think there's a chance. And if the issue remains alive, then the people here can perhaps have a chance to remain alive as well. So keep it going, please.
It's, I think, very nice to end on a positive note. It's so good to see so many people out there are so happy, Helen. Do pass on our very best wishes to those that we haven't had time to link up with their loved ones at home. You're assured that as far as this programme is going, we've already managed to get many thousands of pounds for comic relief, and therefore that money will be on its way to that very camp in which you're sitting at the moment. Thanks for going there, Helen.
It's a pleasure, a real pleasure.
But it's been absolutely marvellous, a magic moment of television. A very, very Merry Christmas to all of you out there. Enjoy the rest of the day, and good luck with the work that you're doing throughout next year.
Thank you. Merry Christmas.
One last one. Well, that's a historic moment, linking up with all those incredible people over there, and talking of money that's on its way to comic relief. How about this? Can you beat Ken Griggs? Hello, Ken. He's at Woodbury Cottage, Old High Road, Yoxford in Suffolk. He's bid £100 for this pullover. Tell you something, Ken, at £100 I'll even send it to the cleaners for you, because it's jolly hot inside here at the moment. Can you beat Ken Griggs? The money will go to Comic Relief, and their address once again, 21 Darblay Street, London W1. Our Whirly Wheel Challenge on this very special edition of the show has been involving how many glasses can you stand on a tray. It's been a show of contrast, you've got to admit that. Up in Manchester, I believe, they have the record. Is it Dave Smith who's got the record?
That's right, Noel.
How many are you claiming there, Dave?
There's 40 trays and 160 glasses.
Well, we want to see you pick them up.
Oh, my God.
You got stuck halfway down Manchester City Hall. Can he get this? A new record. But don't you have to take your other hand away? I thought you had to take your other hand away to get the record. He's just about... Yes, he's done it! He's done it! Wonderful. And where's he going now? At the moment, Heli Telly has managed to see a Merry Christmas on... Can we see that one, please? Can we go, Heli Telly?
Where's that?
Guy's Hospital have done us a Merry Christmas. A very, very happy day to everybody who is watching us in the hospital. We know that lots of people in there are watching the programme, so Merry Christmas, get well soon. Have yourselves a super time.
Obviously cooking there at the moment, aren't they?
Yes. Pebble Mill, Merry Christmas to you all there. I tell you something, we're really helping the plastic beaker industry this Christmas. We're doing a lot there. Who else can we say goodbye to on this Christmas Day? Norwich are leaping around all over the place.
They're shaking them out a bit there.
Yes, fine. And up in Glasgow, well, we keep calling it Glasgow, no doubt the Scots are getting annoyed. It's Linlithgow, but it's our Glasgow crew. Congratulations to everyone in Linlithgow, because they have managed to come up with the largest door that any of our challengers managed to arrive with. And
they're coming back.
Is that the post office too?
Yes. Let's have a look up the post office there.
There's a farmer looking for his barn door back as well. Oh, Cardiff!
Cardiff? Is that Cardiff?
Yeah, you can tell it's Cardiff. It's the size of the people. They're all very short.
Who's this gentleman here? Hello, who are you? Speak to me, sir. The gentleman who's having the microphone pointed at him. Wish someone a Merry Christmas.
John.
Hello, John.
Hello.
Hello. And why are you talking to me?
Well, my wife's about to have a baby any time now.
You should be with her, sir.
Yeah, well, I had to bring this door down here, see?
There's a man who's got his priorities just right, isn't it? Let's get the door down there. Forget the missus. Well, I hope that turns out all right. There's Heli Telly. Mark, Steve, and another Steve, you have our thanks and best wishes. That's Heli Telly over London. They can spin that camera around and take a picture of themselves.
What was amazing flying in the helicopter today was the amount of traffic on the roads. I don't know. We actually got stuck in a jam getting here.
Where's that? That's Newcastle. I recognise the bridge.
Oh, yes.
They've got a car door. Whose car door is it?
Is there anybody there can talk to us?
Newcastle.
Whose car door is it?
Yes. Where'd you get it?
It's off my car.
Really?
Yes, you're mad. Way to get it here.
You're mad. Absolutely mad.
What have you got under that hat? Oh, that's all right.
What's your name, sir?
David Causton.
David, Merry Christmas. Thank you for entering into the lunacy of this show.
Look at that.
Thanks a lot.
There's a bloke there in his dressing gown.
Now, what is that?
Oh, thank heavens.
Yes, I was worried about that.
Oh, hello.
It's Belfast, is it?
Hey,
that's another car door.
Hey, if we keep going around the regions, we'll be able to make one car one piece at a time.
Now, Plymouth, they look a happy, merry bunch there. Oh, look at the little kid at the front. Bored as anything. Merry Christmas, Plymouth. Leeds have given up. Leeds are bored with the whole thing. Thank you, Leeds. Heli Telly is chasing a boat. Let's get this one. The police launch. Merry Christmas to everybody on the Thames.
Oh, yeah, who's that?
That's Bristol. There's the police launch shooting away down the Thames.
That's Heli Telly chasing one of the... Yes, that's the Thames Water Authority. Oh, Thames Police Authority, isn't it?
Just while we're looking at that picture of the boat, a reminder that our phones are manned right through until 2 o'clock. The phones will be still manned until 2 o'clock, so you can get through those dedications for comic relief. Dedications for your family as well, because 637 7171, all those dedications are going on CFAX. Jumbo jet time, and there they are, our team up there. They've had a great run round.
No, we've got the prize for taking a letter.
Yeah, because it was a draw, so they each have got a lovely stereo, and a Virgin record bag.
And we're having a good dinner, isn't it nice?
And Paul King.
Brilliant, he says.
Paul King's still got checker on.
He's still got checker on. There we are. I think we're going
to get... Yeah, Mummy used to do that from here.
Good cabin service on this flight, isn't it?
Where's your dinner?
I don't know. I'm looking for my dinner everywhere. I haven't had anything.
Well, we're going to eat in a minute anyway.
And thanks to all the Virgin Airlines staff, they've been absolutely fantastic today.
Yay!
And Merry Christmas to everybody.
Thank you to the lot of them.
What you got there?
I've got a note here from Steve Montague of Penge.
Yeah.
SE20, hello Steve. Happy Christmas to parents and family in Dorset. He's paying us £140 for your jumper.
Oh, no, not now, dear. You'll see all my wires. Now, we will also be continuing our computer draw because we've got a £1,000 Prestel unit which will be going to somebody from our computer draw. Thank you to the 54,000 people who registered themselves.
Stephen Brown, yeah, from Mansfield in Nottinghamshire, has just bid £25 for my thermal underwear.
Where is it? In Nottinghamshire. The way they smell, I tell you, they'll be on their way any moment. They'll be running up the M1. Have you had a good time?
We've had an excellent time. This jumper's also up for grabs. This is worth at least £200 because it's got built-in party poppers.
637-7171. If you want to give us a call, don't forget the O1 outside London. The phones will be manned till after 2 o'clock. Have we got any unfinished business? I think we've said goodbye to virtually everybody.
There's a shot of us from the heli-telly. Look, you can see us.
Yes,
there.
You can. You can see the top of the tower. You can see the lights at the top of the tower.
Are we leaning or is the heli-telly?
Something's wrong there somewhere. Something is definitely wrong. Well, there are just literally too many people to say a proper thank you to. Obviously... Thank you for
thank
giving
you
up
very
your
much.
Christmas day.
Very
it's enjoyable. Been a real laugh. Everybody up here, we've got volunteers around us, BBC people who have said, yes, we will give up our Christmas. Whatever you think of the last 2 hours, I just hope you get one thing very clear. Have a great day. Happy Christmas from everyone on the show. Bye-bye.